Alrighty then, we're going to use this fact that we just learned, which is pi radians equals 180 degrees, to learn how to convert back and forth between degree measures and radian measures. So we're going to start off by taking 40 degrees, and I want to take that 40 degrees and get a measurement that is going to be in radians. Now, by the way, let's throw this theta up here for a minute. In any kind of advanced math book, if you have a Greek symbol that does stand for an angle measure, so we have an angle which equals 40 degrees, I want that in radians. Well, what we want to do is not change the value of the rotation, I just want to make it look different. So I want to multiply 40 by an equivalent value, I want to multiply it by 1. Think of like reducing fractions. If you have a reduced fraction of 2/3, I can multiply top and bottom by 3 and simply make it look different. But it's still 6/9. So I want to multiply 40 by a value that's equivalent to 1. Now numerically it's not going to be 1, but geometrically it will be an equivalent of 1. I want to take 40 degrees and multiply it. Actually, what I want to do is I want to multiply by something that's going to divide out the measurement of degrees, which is going to be 180 degrees, and multiply in its radian equivalent. Well, what's equal to 180 degrees as far as geometry is concerned? Well, that is, as we just learned, pi radians. Now, I know pi divided by 180 is not equal to 1, but in geometry terms, pi gets you halfway around the circle, and so does 180 degrees. So in geometry terms, this is effectively 1. So this becomes 40 pi over 180. That is, you don't have to take this many steps to reduce, but that'll be 4 pi over 18, which is 2 pi over 9 radians. Now, I do not need to write this word radians to make sure you know that we are in radians. You'll need to be very careful in your reading of your advanced math book to identify that when you see the little circle in the upper right hand corner, that indicates degrees. If you do not, that indicates radians, so me writing this is kind of redundant. Please do not get stuck in the idea that every time you see pi, you're in radians either. You need to look for that degree mark. If it's there, you have degrees. If it's not, even if it's a decimal, you're in radians. So if you multiply by pi over 180, that is going to get you from degrees to radians. If you want to go in reverse, if you want to say take an angle measure that is equal to pi over 4 radians, no degree mark, and convert that into degrees, you will want to multiply by an equivalent of 1 that will take out the radians and put in its place 180 degrees. Now I know again this is not equal 1 mathematically or numerically, but in terms of geometry, halfway around a circle, halfway around the circle, so in geometry terms it's effectively 1. The pi's will cancel out, and you get 180 over 4, which comes out to be 45 degrees, right? Oh wait a minute, I just wrote 45 radians. No, 45 degrees. Okay, so there you go. Okie dokie, so that's converting from degrees to radians and radians to degrees. Last concept. And it's not really a concept, but we're going to ultimately try and build up to the idea of a unit circle, and any work that you do in trig, your teacher should be requiring you to have all those answers in exact form if you're using an angle on something called a unit circle. Now, I'm just going to show you how to come up with the angles around the unit circle. I'm not going to develop the whole concept right now. But let's build up and show you the 16 angles that you have to memorize for the concept of the unit circle, which is coming up very, very soon. Okay, that's a little better. And okay, rough idea of a circle. We're going to have 0 degrees. Now, 16 angles are around the unit circle. You're going to find those 16 angles by counting by 30 degrees. We're going to do degrees first and then go into radians. So I'm going to put my corners, if you will, or my 90 degree marks so I get some kind of correct spacing. And if you want all the angles around the unit circle, again, you count by 30. So 0, 30, 60, 90, 120, 150, 180, somewhere in here, 240, 210, 240, 270, 300, and somewhere around here, 330 degrees. And then we'll get back to 360. And these are all, again, degree marks. Now that's only 12 angles. You need to memorize 16 angles. So the other angles are going to come from my counting by 45 degrees. So again, we're going to count by 30, and then we're going to count by 45 degrees. And those are the biggies to remember, these right here, 30 and 45. So we're going to count by 45s now. We just got done counting by 30. 0, 45, 90, 135, 180, 225, 270, 315, and back to 360. So those are our 16 angles on the unit circle that we must have memorized. Now let's talk about the radian measures, which also must be memorized. If you want to get all your unit circle quizzes done quickly and accurately and get those easy points. And I will quiz my kids to death on the unit circle quiz. And hopefully your teachers are as well. This is hugely important to memorize to make your work later a lot more efficient. Okay, we already know that 180 degrees is equal to pi radians. Now I made this circle by counting by 30 and 45, so let's start with 30. How many 30 degrees are in 180? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, if this is pi radians, and I divide by 6 to get the 30, then 30 is also, in terms of radians, pi over 6. So now, if we counted by 30s to get around the unit circle and make 12 of the 16 angles, we're going to count by pi over 6 to find them in radians. Now, I'm also going to reduce these as we go. So, 1/6 and another 1/6 for another 30 degrees, because again, pi over 6 is 30, you really want to get that memorized. So 1/6, 2/6, 2 over 6 reduces to 1/3. 1/6, 2/6, 3/6 reduces to pi over 2. 1/6, 2/6, 3/6, 4/6 reduces to 2 pi over 3 radians. 1/6, 2/6, 3/6, 4/6, 5 pi over 6. We're just counting by 1 over 6. 6/6, 7/6. Counting every 30 degrees. 7/6, 8 pi over 6. 8 over 6 is 4/3. If you lose count, go back to a 6th because that's the 30 degree denominator. 7/6, 8/6, 9/6. 10/6, again reducing as I go if you're worried about why these denominators are not 6, and 11 pi over 6. And now that's 12 of the radian measures you must have eventually memorized for the unit circle. To find the remaining ones, we counted by 45 degrees, so how many 45s are in 180? Well, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 180 divided by 4 is 45 degrees. So pi divided by 4 is our radian measure. And now we're going to finish off getting our 16 angle measures by adding by pi over 4. So 1/4, 2/4, 3 pi over 4. 4/4, 5 pi over 4. 6 pi over 4, again we already got it, it's reduced, and then finally 7 pi over 4. These are the 16 degree measures and 16 radian measures that are around the unit circle. This will eventually be filled up with the concepts of sine and cosine. How much can I talk about this before I bore you to death or my time runs out? Okay, a few minutes. If you notice these angles, 30 and 60 and 45, and you think back in geometry, those two specialty right triangles that you had to learn, the 45-45 triangle and 60-30 triangle, right? Those triangles are going to help us set up these trig functions of sine and cosine those two special triangles you learned in geometry, the 60-30 and the 45-45, those ratios and the sides of those two specialty triangles are what's going to give us the sine and cosine values eventually in a later lecture that we'll need to memorize around this unit circle. And if you're one of my students, you can build these equations or these angles up and, you know, count them out. When we learn sine and cosine, you can use your special 60-30 and 45 triangles you learn in geometry to build up the sine and cosine values. However, if you're going to keep doing well in my class, if you're going to make your work more efficient through the later stages of trig, and as you move into calculus, you must remember or memorize all of the sine and cosine values around the unit circle, all the sine and cosine values for those 16 angles. Once we get this entire concept of the unit circle set up, I'm Mr. True. That's your introduction to standard position angles and radian measures. Bam! Go do your homework.